Hello, so today we're going to do something slightly different. So me and my friends are playing D&D, and the dungeon master, he asked me to paint up this dragon for the campaign. It's supposed to be an ice dragon, and I've never done it before, but me being the resident painter of the group, I also did our player models. I'm going to give it a shot. So I've never done this before. But, you know, how hard can it be, right? So I was thinking maybe I'll just get like a dark blue. I'll mix this black here with this blue. I'll do a pretty heavy wash over the entire thing. And then I'll just maybe do a faint dry brush with just magic blue. Then another dry brush with electric blue. And then we'll finish off like the tips with some dead white. Like on paper, it sounds really easy. But yeah, we'll see what happens when we actually try to paint it. So tiny bit of black in my little palettes, so you can see. Quite a big chunk of magic blue, big dose of water. I just dipped my shade brush in the water, basically. Take some of that black. I think we're gonna go even darker, just like so. And now we just paint the entire Oh dear, this is thick. But fret not. Just down every single nook and cranny. I can always give it like a wash of some Nuln oil afterwards if I'm not happy with it. If any of you are curious as to why I'm not using an airbrush for this, the simple answer is that I don't actually have one, and I've always sort of been on the fence about it because it just seems I hate cleaning stuff. I hate the very idea of having to like clean the nozzle and all of that just bores me straight up. So like, I mean, I would like to try one, I guess, but it's not really a primary concern of mine. So the paint hasn't even dried yet, but I am really impatient and I just want to get things over with. So about all those hairs stuck, you can see them there. I'm just gonna try to take this little piece of tape and maybe I can like fish them up. Yeah, I got a couple there. Can't seem to get this one. Oh, there we go. Scraped off a little bit of the paint, but it doesn't matter because the recesses are what's important and the tape doesn't get to those bits. So let's just continue. So I've finally removed all the hairs from the paint, and as you can see, it's a bit uneven now because of the tape and because I just like wiped some of them off. But I also realized that I do actually have this shade paint. It's called Drakenhof Nightshade, and it's sort of like a dark blue. And instead of wasting so much extra paint, I'll just use this from now on. So with that, quite frankly, extremely boring part out of the way, you can now see that the entire figure is a very dark blue. Well, except for like here, but it's still very, very dark. And now we're gonna do a dry brush of this magic blue color. Or maybe... I got my COVID shot today, so my arm's a bit gone. Actually, I think we'll take this flat blue instead, just because it seems to be a little bit brighter, and then we're gonna brighten it up even more so with this electric blue. As with any dry brush, we just wipe off the majority of the paint, like so. And now we simply dust on the paint. And the idea here is that blue is going to catch all the raised areas, and as you can see, it does a pretty good job of that. You see, especially like here, And then we're going to work our way up to white, is what I'm thinking. I mean, I'm sure if any of you is a more experienced miniature painter than me, you're going to be like, what the heck is this idiot doing? But, you know, I think it's fun. I think it turns out decent, and, you know, it's not like the end of the world if it doesn't really turn out perfect. Like I said, I'm not really used to painting this scale, so I'm not also not really going to bother with, you know, some people are really picky about painting where the light would hit and whatnot. I'm just gonna go for it. There's not too much method to the madness, so to speak. You can see I've definitely brightened it up, at least. So now what I was thinking is, what if we take this electric blue and we just add some white to it? So, I got the paint down there, just gonna add like a clump of white. I'm gonna mix it a bit hastily. It's just like white mixed with light blue, I guess. Ooh, you see that? That's the kind of contrast I want. And as you can see, I'm not particularly skillful when it comes to this. I'm just layering it on, and there's no real, like, technique involved, so literally anyone can do this. I'm not gonna pretend I'm, like, good at this or anything. I do really like, look how nice and glowing this looks there. I wonder what color I'm gonna paint the eye, because I want the eye to really pop. Maybe like yellow, or maybe, no, red. A little bit more white mixed into this already very light blue. As you can also see, I'm not really waiting until the dry brush has dried, because dry brushes usually dry really fast. This one is making a lot of difference, I notice. Maybe I should have based it in like a lighter blue and then just sort of work myself up to white. Because the more I'm looking at it, the more it looks sort of, I don't know, there's something that doesn't quite strike a chord with me. Okay, I think it's time for white. Actually, because I didn't clean the brush, it's still like a little tint of blue in there. Like, rather more than ice, it sort of looks like some sort of spectral dragon. I don't know, let's paint, like, the tongue and the eyes. So, for the tongue, we'll just do a simple flat red, I feel. Personally, I think the lack of eyes is really making it look a bit land, so... What about this real yellow, maybe?
Now, where are the eyeballs? I can see one, like, here.
Yeah, that looks good. It's still not really white, though. It's still a very light blue. Maybe I just need to... So, I have now cleaned the brush, so we're gonna try this completely white dry brush one more time. Oh, you see that? That's actually white now. Let's try doing it just like from the edges and work ourselves in, because you almost get this sort of snowy effect. Went way too heavy here. You see how dumb that looks? I'm sort of conflicted. Like, I like some of it, but at the same time, it just looks a bit plain. I definitely screwed this bit up. Let's try, like, a light blue wash. Using quite a lot of water because I don't want it to actually, like, cover anything, so... And, you know, if it does cover, then fine, I guess I tried, so... Very loose consistency now. Let's let this dry, but already from here, I think it looks pretty promising. And then we're gonna dry brush with white yet again. So let's try this again with a white dry brush, and we're gonna be very easy on the dry brush. So, now I'm clearly missing some definition for these scales here. Looks alright on this side though, but this side really, really needs it, so... Back to the wash I go. So, I've decided that something is missing, and it's mainly that everything is one color. Well, it's not really one color, but like the scheme is the same throughout the entire thing. So I'm gonna make like the leather in these wings, like leather, I don't know, but I'm gonna make it darker. I'm just gonna bathe it in more of that Drakenhof nightshade, and we'll see how that turns out. So now I'm going to make the spines of the wings a little bit whiter to make them pop. So, with the spines here brightened up, I think the last thing we're gonna do are the teeth. I'm using some flayed one flesh here because it's the closest to beige I got, like a bone color. So we're just going really carefully. You know what? I think this looks alright, but I think I want him even whiter, so... Gonna do one more quick little dry brush of just the white. I actually kind of like the way if I do like the legs, actually, well, a little bit more here, and then if we keep the underbelly like really, really bright. Gives it a little bit more color separation. And because we've used so many different layers of gradient, the transition is quite, I feel like it's quite natural. Like you see, it sort of fades into white from that light blue. Not so much this side, because that's the side I used more washes with. I might go in there and tidy up with some more like a light blue. Push my thumb against it to keep some of the little darker outer, some of those darker recesses. I find the thumb is actually, like, your fingers are quite good at, I don't know, they, just pushing your thumb against, like, drying paint sometimes gives a nice effect. Now we just give it a little white dry brush here. So this is the, well, our ice dragon. I think I'm happy with this. It's not really perfect. I can tidy up like here, but actually it's just like the light. It looks all right in real life. But yeah, my ice dragon, so I'm all right with it. Like I said, I'm not really experienced painting the scale, and honestly, it tests my patience a little bit because of all these layers and whatnot, but it's still like a fun little thing to do. So yeah, thank you for watching and hope you enjoyed.